that we're going to look at a transcribed solo. I've learned an awful lot in transcribing the solo, learning it, writing it down, and it gives me a great opportunity to share with everybody the enlightenment that it brought to me. The solo in question is by Oscar Moore from the Nat King Cole Trio, and it's over Body and Soul, which, as I'm sure many of you are aware, is one of the most played standards of all time. But I think it is relevant just to say a little bit about when this was done, because 1944 is right at the beginning of the story if you're talking about electric jazz guitar playing. Oscar Moore was one of the early soloists, one of the early greats, along with people like George Barnes, Les Paul before he went into the pop recordings later on, and obviously Charlie Christian. And one of the things that I find interesting is that a lot of what came later in jazz guitar, if you listen to people like Jimmy Rainey, Tal Farlow and so on, you can really hear the Charlie Christian influence. And of all of those early players, it's probably Christian that went on to have the most influence over what came later. But there's so much to learn from this solo, and it ties in so well with some of the things that we've talked about before, particularly in terms of things like incorporating the melody and also blending compositional techniques with your improvisation. Okay, let's get right on with it and have a look at this fantastic playing from Oscar Moore. Technicality that you might already have noticed is that the original recording there is actually quite sharp. So my guitar now is in standard tuning, A equals 440, but when I was playing along there with Oscar Moore, I was about 10 cents or so sharp. That's a common problem when you're dealing with transcriptions of old recordings. I suspect they would have tuned to the piano on that date, and also over time, the way these recordings are processed and so on, if something's running at a little bit the wrong speed or something like that, the pitch can creep up or it can go down. So you often find that if you tune your guitar with a tuner and then you want to work with an old recording, you're not going to be quite in tune. It's just one of the perils of the process. As I say though, A equals 440 from now on. Begin with a quote from the melody. Now, one of the interesting things about this recording is nobody really plays the melody. There's one chorus from Oscar Moore and there's one from Nat King Cole. Both of them reference the tune, but there isn't what you might call a head. You know, there isn't a complete rendition of the composed melody. But what you do get is a lot of reference to it. So Oscar, for example, starts with this. That's the first four measures or so, and obviously you can see straight away that the first two measures are really just the written melody. I don't want to labour the point, but if you can't play the written melody of Body and Soul, you really have no right to play a solo on Body and Soul. It's so important that that's informing everything that we do, particularly on a ballad, and it certainly does here. Now straight away you can see some of the things I mentioned just now in terms of the expressive devices. So in the third measure, you have this sort of pick rake through a chord formation through a D-flat major 7, or you could think of it as a D-flat major 9, actually. One of the things that the old jazz guitarists used to talk about all the time, you hear Barney Kessel discussing this and Herb Ellis, is playing from chord formations. They used to talk about chord formations. And you can see here, if I was to put my fingers on the guitar like so, that little arpeggio there in the third measure can actually sound as a chord. So you hear a lot of the time guitar shapes, standard guitar chord shapes that are being arpeggiated, and that's certainly what's happening here. The other point I want to make about this, it applies to all the other similar devices later on in the solo, is you've really got to be careful not to rush when you rake the pick through something like that. And I've actually notated this as separate 32nd notes, in fact, rather than just doing a squiggly line or something like that. Because the goal, it's very difficult to do sometimes, but the goal is that we really want to hear each one of those as a note in its own right, even though it's very quick. If you rush it, it sounds very messy and insecure. There's a little bit of chromaticism involved as well when you get to the top of that arpeggio. The ninth and the seventh of the chord are linked by a chromatic line. And then you've got that lovely first portamento slide right up to the 13th fret. And again, you can hear the melody being referenced there. You know, it is difficult to transcribe. It's particularly difficult to do it if you want to notate things as well. But it's so useful. You can do it in your own time, you can do it in your own way, you can make up your own little codes, and as long as what you write down makes sense to you, nobody else needs to see it. Don't be intimidated by it, don't give up, and don't reach for Google and type in, is there a transcription of such and such somewhere on the internet that I could use? Because if you do that, firstly, you're depriving yourself of the opportunity to get better at it. But also, you know, there is a danger that you're going to learn somebody else's mistakes as well. So I really would encourage you to be self-sufficient on this. It is difficult. Everybody finds it difficult, but know that you're in good company. You know, if you're trying to work something out, my goodness, I've listened to this phrase 60 times and I still haven't got it. That's good, because that's what everybody's had to do. And if you think about those guys back in the day dropping the needle on the shellac record over and over again, Wes Montgomery famously wore out his Charlie Christian records by doing that. And there are so many history stories, you know, about exactly that kind of thing. So, you know, you're in good company. It is difficult, but it can be really fun. And we don't have to necessarily worry about all of these things at once.